All over the country, local authorities are poring over their balance sheets, searching for ways to save money. Road building and maintenance is going to be hit hard. But one of the most controversial expenses for any highways department is salting. Every year until now, some 2 million tons of salt is scattered on Britain's roads. The cost of buying the stuff is about £20 million. The cost of corrosion it causes is much, much more. But is rust the only problem? Duncan Laxon of Lancaster University thinks not. Tony went to a highways depot in Buckinghamshire to meet him.
Duncan Laxon, we're surrounded here in this maintenance depot with literally mountains of road salt. What's wrong with the stuff?
Well, in addition to the enormous costs due to corrosion, there are a wide range of hidden costs associated with salting our roads. About a third of the salt that's put onto the roads is thrown onto the roadside verges, where it kills off the vegetation and causes a deterioration in the soil structure. But the majority of the salt is washed into the streams and rivers adjacent to the roads, and here it can be damaging the aquatic life in these rivers and streams. And it can also be getting into the water supplies of this country. And this is perhaps the most important aspect, as it's recently been found that salt, the sodium part of salt, causes various diseases. Hypertension is one associated with heart disease. And this is quite a worrying situation, as we're putting ever-increasing amounts of salt onto the roads and thence into the streams.
Well, we've established that it costs roughly £20 million a year to buy the stuff. Is there any way of estimating in real money terms what these environmental and social effects that you're saying salt has actually cost us?
Well, a recent report from the United States Environmental Protection Agency gives us the first clue to this. They suggest that the cost to the environment of applying all this salt is about 15 times the cost of buying the salt in the first place.
So in pound notes in the UK, what's that?
It comes to a figure of about £500 million each year in this country.
That's quite a lot of money, isn't it? Does all this research of yours lead you to the conclusion that we're using too much salt, or that we shouldn't use salt at all?
Well, before we can determine whether we should use salt at all or how much to use, we must know why we're using the salt. Perhaps the most forceful argument used for salting is that it improves safety on the roads, but unfortunately there's no evidence to support this contention. And in fact, it's possible that salting may be making the situation more dangerous, in that it gives drivers a false sense of security. They see a salted road that has the appearance of being wet, whereas the road is in fact still more slippery than a wet road, and it's possibly then more dangerous for them to drive on. And there's evidence come from the States and Canada which suggests this might be the case.
But surely it's better to drive on even a salted wet road, however slippery, than it is to drive on an icy road.
Well, salting roads certainly reduces disruption and delays. And for this reason, we should probably salt the roads to some extent. But we must determine how much salt we should be putting on the roads. And I would suggest that we could probably reduce salting to about a quarter of our present levels and still maintain safe driving conditions on the road without too much delay or disruption.
Finally, how much would this save us if we reduce salting by what you're suggesting, which is three quarters?
It would save £10-20 million each year. And this would be a saving to taxpayers, ratepayers and car owners in this country.
But apart from expensive under-road heating, there does seem to be no other sure way of preventing your car from slipping off the motorway when it's iced up, then putting salt down. So let me ask Brian Royal, as Deputy County Engineer for Buckinghamshire, presumably salt is going to be one of the things that we're going to be seeing less of over the coming year with the cutbacks.
Well, not very much less, I hope. Certainly not on the major routes. We shall concentrate on the principal traffic routes, and any cut back in the use of salt will be mainly on the minor country roads.
But you're still convinced that salt is efficacious?
Oh, very efficacious indeed, yes.
What about the rest of the cuts? Now, you're losing £750,000 off your maintenance budget of about £4.5 million over the coming year. Where are the cuts going to fall?
Well, there'll be a reduction in things like road sweeping, verge maintenance, and the activities of the village maintenance gangs.
Thank you. What about maintenance of more major routes?
Maintenance of the major routes, there's a cutback there, of course, on structural maintenance. Quite a severe one, again, something over 30%. We spend a lot of money on haunching, resurfacing of carriageways.
Now, haunching is where you build up the side of a fairly small road when it's taking heavier traffic than it was designed for.
That is right, yes. When the edge of the carriageway fails due to overrunning, particularly by these heavier vehicles, we find the most effective way is to excavate part of the edge of the carriageway, plus part of the haunch as well,
and
part
it,
of the verge.
And build it up again.
And build up a good, strong haunch.
So does that mean that the edges of the roads are going to start breaking up?
Well, it's inevitable that this will occur. We shall have to patch them rather than haunch them. But this does not hold as well, of course, as a haunch.
Now, you're going to be using lots more of the dreaded grit, aren't you?
Well, I wouldn't say lots more. Obviously, there will be a greater proportion of surface dressing rather than resurfacing.
But, I mean, this is the motorist's nightmare, isn't it? Are you suggesting we should all take out shares in a windscreen company?
No. If people drive sensibly on these roads, which have been resurfaced, then there is no problem. We always put out boards indicating that resurfacing has been carried out. Please drive slowly, loose chippings or something of that order, legend of that type. And if people do take notice of these, this drastically reduces the possibility, in fact, of windscreen damage.
We're also seeing a lot of potholes appearing, I mean, all round the country, not obviously just in Bucks. What should we do about potholes? Because, of course, the council is responsible if we damage our motor cars by driving into your potholes.
Yes, if the council is aware that there is a pothole there, then obviously they must do something about making it safe to see that it's not a hazard to the motorist.
There have been suggestions that potholes should be signposted. Are you going to be signposting the potholes that occur?
Well, we certainly wouldn't signpost an individual pothole because it would obviously be cheaper to fill the pothole than it would to signpost it.
So, no pothole signpost.
We have no policy for signposting potholes, no.
Now, just how are we going to be able to drive on these new, shall I say, less well-maintained roads? Do we drive more slowly with more care?
Well, obviously, this must be so, yes. If the carriageway surface is seen to be not of the high standard to which you are accustomed, then obviously the motorist should drive with greater care.
Now, we can see the reason for emergency economy measures, but aren't you just saving up trouble for the future? Won't the day come when you've got to spend a lot of money getting back to where you would have been some years before?
As highway engineers, we are very concerned about this, very concerned indeed, because obviously a cutback now in expenditure may very well result in our having to spend a lot more money in the future.